Several of my YouTube subscribers email me regarding the Sweep2 surface, so we're gonna spend some time to talk about it today. Hi, welcome back to PJ Chen Design Channel. This channel is about sharing Rhino 3D knowledge to students and 3D model professionals, learning various Rhino techniques. Are you ready? Let's get started. When we're working with Sweep2 Rails surface, we will have this window come up, and then this window we're gonna talk about the difference on top three. The first one, I already have pre-made this rail here. Let's take a look on the perspective view. All right, so the red one will be my rail and the green one will be the cross section. So let's go to the surface, Sweep2 rail, and you got rail one, rail two, and then it is the open curve cross section. We click on all of them, then we will have the surface like this. I'm going to move that into this section here for not changing the cross section. The second thing we want to try is the second option by changing the cross section. So here is the Sweep2 rail. We go rail 1, rail 2, and the same cross section. Then we have this dialog coming up. Right here, you can change as many as you want. You can pretty quick to see this is a preview here. And the cross section by become more of the point, so we set it for 12 point. Then I'm going to click OK. And this section, actually, I already have one made here. So you can already know the surface is slightly different. In the render view, it's actually not much of a difference, but you're going to see the difference when you turn on the control point. The third one is actually going to change the height. You can refit the cross section within certain distance. We're not gonna do that because that's pretty much for the same like the second one. So we are talking about maintain the height here. Let's go to the Sweep2 surface again. We have rail one, rail two, cross section. Again, coming with the dialogue window, we wanna make sure we maintain the height. And what it does is the height will maintain and will go smooth from the first cross section to the second cross section. I already make another one there. If you go by the comparison from the second one, which is the green, and also the third one is the maintain the height. You can see the third one coming down smoother. The first one, the height actually go by the distance in between this rail and the first rail and the second rail. All right, so the very last one we want to try, we have to go from the top view in order to see it. Okay, so we're gonna go into the surface again, Sweep2 rail, and again, first one, first rail, second rail, and you cross section and cross section. All right. Now, nothing is different here. We still maintain the high. Okay, we do not want to change the cross section. We'll try to keep the wireframe as square as possible. So you have the option right here. It's called add slash. All right, so what we wanted to do is we want to go as 90 degrees as possible. Okay, so I'm gonna go from rail one and then move it to the rail two, and that's trying to do as 90 degrees as possible. Okay, so keep all of them into more of a square looking. I think this is good here. All right, and then if we like that, we can click okay. If not, you can add more slash in there. All right, so what it does is it gives you more uniform looking. Now let's take a look on how are those surfaces it's going to affect the look on the mesh. So I'm going to make them into the mesh, and let's try fewer polygons, easier to see in that way. Okay, so I'm gonna select all the mesh that we just create and move them into this box right here. Now if you take a look on this, you can kind of notice the first one and the second one, they are very zigzag. You can see the, you know, the edges is really zigzag. And also, that's actually because it's a low polygon, you're probably gonna see that anyway. But what is going to be interesting is by comparison, you're going to see those is more like kind of, in some point, they're kind of folding into themselves. This one is not as bad as you can see from the original surface. Is more squarish looking, and this one is come out really good. As you can see, the area is really smooth. So let's turn into the render view. Let's do some comparison. What I wanted to look at it is the angle right here. You see, even in this the mesh, it's kind of very smooth. Compared to this one, you can see how rough the surface is. And sometimes this is a simple form. Sometimes when you have really complicated, like if the curve is like a really small radius, it kind of curving into it, like a lot of like scoring work, then you may have a problem. It's like too much turning. Once you turn into the mesh, they kind of break it. So in some scenario, you have no naked edges on the surface, a nerve surface, but you do have a naked edges on the mesh. That is why is that happen. Okay, so we try to create use this method to understand what is the better surface. Okay, now the other scenario is instead of the open curve as a cross section, we do have closed curve as a cross section. And what I mean is, if we do surface sweep to rail, and this is rail one, this is rail two, and you go from here to here to here, okay, and this is where the direction should go. Imagine that I'm gonna call the rail one is interior, rail two is exterior. All the points should be lined up exactly at the same point, okay? And then all the arrows should go into the same direction. In this case, they are face down. So let's take a look on that. Then we will have a very nice surface right there, okay? That was, I already did that one, so that was the same like that surface. So we have that one there. What happened if the arrow is not aligned? So rail one, rail two, you got first, second, third. And I'm gonna flip it. You go to click on the arrow. On the second one, I'm gonna flip it up. So that means when this cross section turning into here, it's going to be turned, going to the opposite direction and then coming back with another opposite direction. And let's see what happened here. Okay, so you see the form was like this is because, well, the arrow was lined up, but it was in the opposite direction. That's why it caused this issue. So it folded twice. This is the first one right here. This is the second one right here. As you can see, they are kind of cross. Okay, so we try to align with all the arrow. What happened if the dot is not aligned? Let's go to sweep to rail again. Rail one, rail two, cross section here, here, and here. Okay, instead of a line right there, I'm going to move an arrow to the other direction. So you can see that they are not aligned. However, the direction is the same. So let's see what happened. Is I'm going to click OK. Okay, and what happened is this was circle, and because it's going to turn in here and become the oval, you can kind of see the form is kind of twist itself. And then coming back, twist again, back to the circle, all right? So if your arrow position is on a line, the form itself, it will twist. It's almost like turning 90 degrees in my case. So even though they are following your rail, so they won't be exactly match your rail, okay? So that's why make sure that all the arrow position is aligned and the direction is aligned too. Otherwise, you will have some sort of a arrow like this. This is not really an arrow, but it may not be exactly what you are looking for. I hope today's tutorial is helping you understand more about how to use the sweep to surface option. Please like and comment and share my video because that's helping my ranking on YouTube, and that's the only way that I can keep making free tutorial for you. Thank you for watching. I will see you next Monday.